It is my distinct pleasure to invite you, Charlie Batch, to address the class of 2013.
Thank you. It is truly a tremendous honor to be able to stand up in front of you today as now a member of Washington and Jefferson. This morning, I was driving down the road. I'm down 79, and I got to thinking to myself, who was my commencement speaker 15 years ago? I got to 70 East, and I still asked that same question. So, not to the middle of the group, just look to the outside. By a show of hands, how many people in there remember your commencement speaker? Great. Because that means my message is not meant for you all. It is meant for the center of the room. You all are prepared, you have been waiting for this moment, and you are ready. If you were to go out here right now and your cell phone rang and it was the call that you've been waiting for because you applied for a job 3 months ago, are you ready? Are you ready for that opportunity to now maybe put your ego to the side because the job offer is not what you submitted? Will you look at that as a challenge for you to go out there and now do something greater? Use it as a challenge, and now we'll use it as a stepping stone. That's up to you to decide. All I know is for the last 11 years, as a member of the Pittsburgh Steelers, there were 196 games that I participated in. And my number was called 11. Now, for all you mad geniuses out there, that's an average of one time a year. Are you going to take advantage of that opportunity? For me standing in front of it, millions of people would be exposed to my flaws if I wasn't able to go out there and produce. I use that as a challenge to see what I wanted to do. Because as you go through this, you know there's younger players that are always coming around to replace you. So I never wanted to give the coach, the general manager, or the owner an opportunity to say, you want to know what? He wasn't prepared to do his job. Some of you all right now know about resilience because a lot of you all have experienced the death of a student member. I know what that felt like. I remember being there where you were at. 17 years ago, February 18, 1996, that day changed my life forever. I remember being in college at Eastern Michigan, receiving a phone call from my mother, and she says, Charlie, you need to come home. I said, what do you mean I need to come home? She said, pack your bag and come home. So I'm packing my bag full of nothing because I had no idea what I was packing to come home for. I said, Mom, you need to tell me before I get on this road, which is a 5-hour drive from Detroit to Pittsburgh, why I'm coming home. At that point, the deepest wallow that I've ever heard in my life, she said, Charlie, your sister's been shot and killed. She was 17 years old. I remember driving down the road, driving down the Ohio Turnpike, I get into Pennsylvania, and I finally get to Homestead. And some of you all have been to Homestead, you go to the waterfront. I wasn't there. So at that point, I'm driving across, Steel Mills blacked out. I get to a street called East Laurel Way. I get there, there's still yellow tape. There's blood on the ground as I'm looking around, and I'm trying to figure out what happened. When I got the story, she was caught in crossfire between rival gangs. But the guy that she was with used her as a body shield. Danielle was 17 years old. She never had an opportunity to live life. She would be 34 years old today. And at that moment, I said to myself, you need to make a change. There was a quote that Dr. Martin Luther King, and it says, it's not where you stand during comfort and convenience, but it's how you stand during challenge and controversy. If I did what I wanted to do then, I wouldn't be standing in front of you here today. You have no idea who Charlie Batch was. You have an opportunity right now to make a change. You've been through that. What is resilience? It's the ability to adapt to change and misfortune. What are you going to do? How are you going to seize the moment? So when you look back at it, you are now having an opportunity to go out there and challenge yourself. The only person that you can be better than was the person that you were yesterday. That is it. So you had a chance to go out there and do the impossible. What's the impossible? To some people, it's doing something that people say that never can be done. Let me take you to a date that is December 3rd, 2012. There's a kid from Homestead playing on the road in front of 70,000 people. And he said, the Steelers cannot go into Baltimore and beat the Ravens as they are going for their 16th game in a row. What happens? We're on the 15-yard line, 6 minutes and 51 seconds left. I'm standing here, I'm looking around, I'm just like, wow. There probably was 11 people, maybe 53 people on that field that thought that we can get it done. Because the way that I played in Cleveland the week before, there's absolutely no way that you all thought that we were going to get it done. No way. My mother didn't even think that we were going to get it done. So as I'm standing out there on the minus 15-yard line, 6 minutes and 51 seconds left, we're going down the field methodically, pass to the right, pass to the left, first down after first down, and now here we are with 2 seconds on the clock, lining up for a field goal, doing something that nobody thought that we can do. So I'm standing on the sideline, and I'm saying, I can't watch. Some of you all might have been watching that, looking at the TV, probably couldn't watch with you. I turn around and I said, you wanna know what? I didn't came too far to not watch this moment. I turn around, there's a snap, there's a hold, and there's a kick. The ball is through the uprights, and all I can envision at that point is two Steeler fans with their hands through the uprights like this. What better way for you to doubt millions of people watching, but better yet, silence 70,000 people all at once? When I look out here, I see you, and I challenge you, and I want you to expect your best. Because 17 years ago, someone asked me that question, and I know some of you all might be asked that question. Are you mad about the death of a family member? And you have a right to say yes, because you are mad. But I want you to look at it the way that I did, and to go out there, and when somebody asks you, are you mad? You tell them yes, because you are making a difference. That's what I want you to go out there and do. There's a quote by Ralph Waldo Emerson, and it's a quote that says, do not go where the path may lead. Go instead where there is no path and leave a trail. I can't sit up here and tell you what it's going to take for you to become a 15-year NFL veteran. I can't tell you what it's going to take for you to get to 3 Super Bowls and win 2 and have 2 Super Bowl rings. All I'm going to tell you is this. There's a right way and there's a wrong way. Ultimately, it is up to you to decide what you want to do. I challenge you to go out here and make a difference. We are all here, and I am a member at the Washington and Jefferson family. So as you go out there and you continue this journey, which is called life, continue to go out and represent Washington and Jefferson with honor and dignity. Congratulations to the 2013 graduating class, and I will be here for you.